It is time for a short break. Up next.
There was yellow crime tape stretched all the way across 6th Avenue, like around Grand Street. Yellow crime tape at a time like this? I mean, is there enough yellow crime tape for a crime this big?
Terrorism in your own backyard. The September 11th tragedy seen through the eyes of performance artist and Tribeca resident, Reno. Roma's review of Reno, Rebel Without a Pause, is coming up.
Stay tuned for more On Stage after this. Now, welcome back to On Stage.
Welcome back. Late last summer, comic monologuist Reno was at work on another of her highly topical shows. But when the tragedy of September 11th unfolded right in Reno's backyard, she dropped what she was doing and changed the focus of her writing. The result, a new piece entitled Reno, Rebel Without a Pause, Unrestrained Reflections on September 11th. The show debuted downtown at La Mama last fall, and this spring it transferred to the new Zipper Theater in the Garment District. And now, joining me with her review of that production is Roma Torrey. Roma?
Okay, thank you, Donna. Well, if you have seen as many Broadway shows as I have the past couple of months, and it has been a lot, you might understand how a steady diet of Broadway, with all its often bloated excesses, can feel, well, sort of unhealthy, kind of like eating little else than Godiva chocolates for a while. So I craved a return to basics, and I went off to see Rebel Without a Pause. And compared to all that rich Broadway fare, monologuist Reno is like a very tasty, highly seasoned tofu. A bit strange, but natural and good for you, too.
Do I seem depressed, people? I'm not depressed. I'm angry, but I'm not depressed.
A mostly bare stage and a performer just speaking, well, ranting mostly, Reno is a force of nature, calling it as she sees it. The topic is stated in the subtitle, Unrestrained Reflections on September 11th. And this resident of Tribeca, living in the shadow of the World Trade Center, certainly has a wealth of material to reflect on.
I guess I was awakened by the impact of the first plane into the building, and, I woke up and I thought, suicide bombers, and I went back to sleep. Serious. Because, I don't know, that's how I think. I thought I was kidding.
She is so left-leaning, you can almost see her right foot leave the ground. But the politics don't matter so much as the passion behind the material. It's heartfelt, and it's brutally honest, and certainly funny. And anyone who can find genuine humor in the events surrounding 9/11 certainly deserves our attention.
Now we're down, and there's this whole line of people leaving the neighborhood, right? And now we're like, the Newvale refugees of Tribecistan.
As Reno so gamely verbalizes the unthinkable, her off-the-cuff, halting delivery brings to mind Woody Allen, with a little Joan Rivers mixed in. Her observations can be brilliantly on target and at the same time outrageously provocative. But certainly the beauty of such a show and the point she hammers over and over is that 9/11 should remind us that America is all about freedom, even at the most awkward times. And for that reason, such a show is not only good for my diet, it's good for the theater, and good for the soul. Donna.
It's interesting. I know right after 9/11, a lot of people were looking for kind of comfort food, like escapist fare in their theater. But she came up with the show just a few weeks after 9/11, and she was drawing audiences.
And there was some concern that there was a little bad taste involved there, but she brilliantly pulls it off. Mm-hmm. Whether you agree with her or not, you got to hand it to her. I mean, she's the real deal,
yeah.
And she feels everything she says, and she demands respect for that. And I think she deserves to be seen.
Yeah. Okay, I like that tofu analogy, too.
I don't think she would, but...
Okay.